Good morning to all of you. Today, let us discuss the validity of e-contracts as per the Information Technology Act 2000. Right? So friends, you may be knowing the contents of a contract according to section 10 and according to section 13 of the Indian Contract Act. There should be offer, acceptance and consideration. These three points are most important in the so-called contract. Then only, even though there is a meeting of minds of two or more persons, the offer, all these things should be there then, and that too, it should be according to section 10, it should be in consonance with law. Then only it is a legal or valid contract. This is as per Contract Act. Right. So, for example, if you want to submit the, now let us come to the Information Technology Act. Here, with the advent of technology, now we are going towards the paperless governance. So without using paper, we are able to transact. Previously, if at all, any document is required, the court insists that it should be in writing, stamped, sealed, like that, all these things are there. So instead of that, legal recognition of electronic records is the main aim of the Information Technology Act. Please refer to section 4, where if any law provides that the information or any other thing shall be in writing or typewritten or printed, then if such information is transmitted electronically, yes, it is also allowed. It is rendered available or rendered legal under section 4 of the so-called Information Technology Act. Now, what is a contract? We discussed. Then, how it is legally relevant according to section 4. Please remember, with the advent of the Information Technology Act, the Indian Penal Code, the Evidence Act, the RBI Act and so many others, they have been actually amended. So, you have to remember section 65A and B of the Evidence Act. So, 65A and B, what they say is that in place of paper, the electronically submitted material is sufficient. That's why, according to that only, the so-called video conferencing, section 65B of the Evidence Act, even according to Information Technology Act, video conferencing is being allowed. It is legal. It is lawful. Likewise, so, normally, if at all any contract has to be executed, normally some people, now they have, we have gone to the stage of reverse contracts. Okay, let us not bother. But anyway, global contracts. So, you want to construct, you want to go for bidding a dam in Singapore, yes, you can sit in your office and send the contract or send your bid through email. Electronically, it is accepted. Previously, what you have to do, you have to offer your quoting, you have to each and everything A, B, C, D, for this, then you have to put your signature, cover it, then go to the box and actually you have to place it in the box if it is in India. But now, situation has changed. It is legally recognized. So, how it is legally recognized, you may be knowing. In place, this is the trend of electronic or digital signatures. According to section 24, digital signature is valid in place of the original signature because it is developed through the asymmetric crypto system. Already I took encryption part, I told you also asymmetric system. That means public key and private key, simply to say. Right? So, the record, it has to be acknowledged. Please refer to section 13, clause 2, I believe. According to section 10A, please refer to section 10A. Validity of contracts formed through electronic means. So, if you send the contract through electronic means, definitely it is valid. It is, since it is in expressed form. So, you are booking, you are going to contract with Flipkart, order something. If it doesn't send, yes, it's a failure, then you can file a case against him, just like the contracts. And refer to section 13 clause 2, I think that is more important. Because if you send the electronic message or electronic contract, if the electronic record is seen by the other party, right, in the designated computer course, and if the receipt occurs then it is deemed to have been acknowledged. Finish. Right, now we will go to the very famous case, PR Transport Agency versus Chapthana. Manch case adi lede PR Transport Agency. Yes. So, PR Transport Agency through its partner Sri Prabhakar Singh versus Union of India 2006. Here what happened is the BCCI, that is Bharat Coking Coal India. So, they have they called for tenders for the bidding of coking coal from its mines. Yes. PR Transport Agency, yes, they have sent their contract and initial money they have to pay something, they have paid, and the BCCI received the initial amount and said that the contract has been approved or acknowledged and also approved. Then he has paid the remaining amount of 81.15 lakhs or so. Then he is waiting for the coke to be transported. They are transport agency. So, in spite of his so many reminders, ultimately, after 1 year, they have received a message that due to technical reasons, due to unknown technical reasons, they have cancelled the tender and they did not give back the money. Then he filed a case. In this case, the main important point is when once, here it is very clearly stated that when once, so e-auction for, this is regarding e-auction for coal, right? So, the petitioner submitted his tender, right, through e-contract and it was accepted. And acceptance letter was also issued by the company to the petitioner's email address. PR Transport, Prabhakar Singh, he has got the acceptance letters also. And later, he deposited the full money by check, 81.15 lakhs. The check was accepted and it was also encashed, right? Subsequently, instead of delivering the coal to the petitioner was informed by an email. So, they did not send the coal. He was informed that e-auction in his favor was cancelled due to some technical and unavoidable reasons. This is the communication they sent. Actually, some other person offered a good bid and therefore they have cancelled. Laterally, it is due to political influence. Of course, this was there. And these people, they raised the jurisdiction point objections also because the contract was done at Chandauli, yes, near Varanasi. Of course, luckily, Chandauli and Varanasi, both places are in Allahabad High Court jurisdiction. Therefore, so the Allahabad High Court has taken cognizance of the matter. So, what they have written is, the contract became complete by receipt of the acceptance of the offer. That's why acceptance offer, all these things. At Varanasi. Both the places belong within territorial jurisdiction of the High Court, Allahabad High Court. So, no problem. This court has got jurisdiction to entertain the difficulty, to entertain the writ petition. Right? So, the acceptance having received by the petitioner, right, with this acceptance, the contract became complete. Right? So, therefore, they have to pay back the contract. However, it has been examined ouster clause. So, they have to pay back the entire amount with some compensation. So, likewise, many cases are there. Since it is a very small question, please remember. So, the very purpose of the Information Technology Act is to make the electronic documents legal in place of the old and statutory white paper signatures. Whenever the court asks for any document, any written document, in place of the document, you can send the electronic record with a digital signature because it is having the asymmetric crypto system, encryption crypto system. So, therefore, it is 100% valid, right? Actually, the purpose, anyway, the IT Act is framed only to make e-commerce into the main platform. Luckily, the information technology has come up and therefore they have added it also. Even it is not sufficient, now artificial intelligence has also come into this. Anyway, as far as the problem is concerned, e-contract, it is valid in place of the paper record. So, please remember section 4, section 10A and section 13, clause 2, and you will definitely get good marks. Thank you.